and welcome back to freesciencelessons.co.uk. By the end of this four-part video, you should be able to describe physical separation techniques. Now, these include filtration, crystallization, distillation, and chromatography. In the last video, we looked at filtration and we looked at crystallization. In this video, we're going to look at distillation, so let's get started. When we looked at crystallization, we saw that we can evaporate a liquid, such as water, from a solid, leaving us with crystals just like this. The problem is, what do we do if we want to keep the liquid? Well, in this case, we use distillation. So distillation can be used to separate a liquid from a solid if we want to keep the liquid. Now, I should point out that we call this simple distillation. There is another technique called fractional distillation, and this allows us to separate two different liquids. We're going to look at fractional distillation in the next video. So how does simple distillation work? Well, there are two stages to this process. First, we evaporate the liquid by heating. We then condense the vapor back to a liquid by cooling. Let's look at the apparatus that we use to do this. We place our solution with the liquid and the dissolved solid in this flask here. This flask is now connected to a continuous glass tube, which I'm showing you with this yellow arrow here. The glass tube is surrounded by a jacket, which we call the condenser. Cold water from the tap continuously runs through the condenser, and by doing this, it keeps the internal glass tube cold. After running through the condenser, the water simply goes down the sink. We've also got a thermometer as part of the apparatus here. So let's see how this works. We start by heating our solution, for example, by using a Bunsen burner. As we heat the liquid, it starts to evaporate, turning into a vapor. This vapor now rises up the glass tube, like this. The thermometer shows us that the temperature is rising, but actually with simple distillation, we usually just boil the liquid. The vapor now passes into the condenser. Remember that the condenser is kept cold because we're circulating cold water around it. This means that the vapor now condenses, turning back into a liquid as it passes through the condenser, like this. We can collect the liquid in our beaker, so at the end, we're left with crystals of our solid in the flask here, and our liquid is in the beaker here. So that's simple distillation. Simple distillation can be used to produce drinking water from seawater. However, a great deal of energy is required for simple distillation, so generally it's not used to make drinking water. Other techniques are used instead. Okay, so hopefully now you can describe how simple distillation can be used to separate a liquid from a solid if we want to keep the liquid.